Before going anywhere, a certain claim must be addressed. There are some people who claim that Gaddafi was in contact with NATO, who promised him a safe passageway out of Sirte. This claim was boosted by American investigative journalist Wayne Manson, who claims Gaddafi was double-crossed upon leaving Sirte, then executed. He claims that on early October 19th, Twitter messages reported the presence of white flags across Sirte. He claims Gaddafi was told to surrender to the rebels before morning prayers at 5 a.m., but it was decided that the surrender occurred after the sun was well up, so the white flags could be clearly visible. However, Mr. Wayne continued, Gaddafi attempted to flee Sirte and to avoid surrender. Other sources on the same line as Mr. Wayne claim Gaddafi had continuous diplomatic communications with the UK. They claim when Secretary of State Hillary Clinton visited Libya, the British informed Gaddafi of a diplomatic agreement that would be triggered when he left Sirte for another safe haven. But in reality, it was all a trick to get him to leave Sirte so as to kill him.
Another source was from the South African Intelligence Services, which investigated the role of a British company in a mission to help Gaddafi flee Libya. In the report, a former policeman in the South African Security Services claimed he was sent to Libya and spoke with Gaddafi, who told him he wanted to leave and settle in a desert-like area in South Africa. A British firm and a Kenyan woman who recruited mercenaries were both subjects of interest for the investigation, as both claimed to have attempted to free Gaddafi from Sirte to an escape destined to fail. To add to this, Reuters reported on September 27 that Gaddafi loyalists sought a truce with an NTC commander. In the report, an unnamed commander with the Libyan interim government claimed he held truce talks with an elder of Gaddafi's tribe. Tahami Zahani, a commander of Al-Farwa Brigade, claimed the same elder contacted him on his satellite phone and requested a safe passage for the families and militia out of the city. Mr. Wayne and a handful of others claimed Gaddafi's convoys had white flags on them. A study of these sources shows that the root cause of their claims was their lack of understanding on why Gaddafi left Sirte in broad daylight instead of nighttime. They argue that it would be unlikely for Gaddafi to have left Sirte in a convoy knowing NATO bombers awaited him. But that statement alone shows their ignorance to the truth, as Gaddafi and Mutasim originally planned to leave Sirte at 3 a.m. Also, Gaddafi left Sirte with full knowledge and acceptance of his impending doom. There is no proof of Gaddafi directly speaking to NATO, as sources claim, as Gaddafi was cut from the world, as reported by the people who were with him in those last days. The idea of diplomatic talks taking place were intended to confuse people and create fear that Gaddafi might betray his country for the sake of a safe passage out. There was never any possibility of diplomacy with NATO. How could a people negotiate away their sovereign rights and freedoms with an illegitimate occupier? Some sources claim Gaddafi was on his way to meet NATO officials to conduct a truce, but we know from primary sources that Gaddafi was leaving for his home village with the intention to die there. There is no proof of white flags across Sirte, at least not in District 2, or on Gaddafi's convoy. It was another well-manufactured lie spread by both the corporate and sensationalist alternative media.